the crisis now impacts the Islamic institutions, we have to differentiate between two things, between individual institution and the global sector. The global is, of course, because the institutions or these banks is part of the global instrument. But as an individual banks, no. Why? Because they cannot enter any non-compliance instrument which could lead to the crisis. That's why most of the all the Islamic institutions are not involved in this, which has caused the crisis. But as a global, yes, of course, because they are one of these global shortage of money, collapse of the institutions, raising the debt, all these could affect indirect way to the Islamic finance. Unfortunately, the liquidity, lack of liquidity in Islamic banking, this is the most important problem that could face the Islamic institutions. That's why I think in the future you will face a lot of merger between the Islamic institutions to solve this problem. It's a good idea to have a lot of Islamic institutions, but since the weaknesses comes from the shortage of money, of liquidity, that's why to be merger more better than to have individual, a lot of individuals, institutions which is have capitals, cannot survive them for at least 10 years or 20 years. That's why we believe merging between the Islamic banking is better than have a lot of numbers of Islamic institutions to face these kind of problems. The merger has to be international. This is what I believe. Yeah, because you know the crisis is too much to struggle alone with the small institutions. The mergers, it has to be international. This is the challenge. Islamic banking, Islamic finance has to develop every time to face the needs of the markets, the needs of the people. You know, you cannot depend on the products which will be like more than 40 years ago. We have to think about a new product can cover the new needs or needs of the society or needs of the countries. If you compare between the conventional products and the Islamic financial products, you will see a big difference and big gap, because you know the conventional banks, they depend on lending and borrowing, and that's it. Whatever you need, whatever you want, lending and borrowing, and full stop. But for Islamic banking, no. It depends how the customer and what kind of needs of the customer. We can custom made the products, the contracts for different people, a different level of people as well. A lot of projects that having Qatar in a few years, they have Islamic finance. They have very good and awesome product, which is constructions product. That means whatever you want to construct, you can have these contracts with the Islamic institutions. Moreover, they can have different parties start or joining together with this contract, which is depending in how many parties can be in the project. For example, the construction contract can depend on three main things, which is the Islamic institutions, the client, and the construct or the so these three parties, they can join together, and they have sub parties inside, which is very useful for society and for the country as well. And this is one. And second, they have also al-mudaraba, which is I have money and you have the idea, I give you the money and you work with this idea and to make a construction, whatever we can decide from the beginning. Also, we have a partnership, which is you have money, I have money, we can decide, we can go through the different project. This kind of instrument, which is very useful than the conventional, which is lending money and that's it. So it depends on the customer and the client. What he needs, they can provide.